This conference will now be recorded.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, ma'am.
Before we start with the today's session, do you have any doubts for the previous classes? Reply me, yes, no, say something. Okay, fine. So let's continue with the remaining things, what we have to do with the functions. Okay, so first let me share with the screen. So last class we have found that in a which position that number of characters is available. Now we are just continuing with the same thing. So we are using a customer name. I'll go for this create a calculation field. So now we are going to use function length. So we have done this in Excel also. So same thing we are doing here. Length means the number of characters including this space. Including the space, how many number of characters we have. So I say here length. Length, that is length. String, I want to know the customer name. Customer name, how many characters. So see here, length. Here is an option as calculation. The total number of characters is 11. The same way. Customer name, the number of characters. So A-A-R-O-N space B-E-R-G-M-A-N. So the first one must be 11 characters. Okay, 11 characters. So we will see how it will show us. I'll click on this OK. So I got this function 11, length. I'll drag this and drop it here. Now see a function 11. So this has to show me the 11 characters, but instead of what it is showing me, it is showing me the 78. So wherever there is a same A option which is starting, it is adding it one to the another values, it is adding. So what we will do, this sum of functions len, we will go here, convert this into attribute. Now see, it says here A-A-R-O-N space B-E-R-G-M-A-N. So yes, yeah, it is 13 characters. So 13 characters is being displayed. Okay, so you can see this. So length character. You can try this length. If you are done, let me know, okay?
Ma'am, can you show the find third A's position once again, like the calculate what we have to write for that?
Okay, this we have done in the last class. So in that case, I'll show you this. Find the third character's position. right? So suppose now, if suppose there is a word, so let me do the next one. I will use here. Okay, wherever there is a E, second time repeated, then that we will find out. So what we will do, I will go for this, create a calculation, find second E's position. This I'm doing. So now what we will do, find nth, okay, find the value of this position, find the nth position. So this is what we are doing. Now see here, they have given an example, calculation. I need the A position of the second one. So A 1, C is 1, A is 2, L 3, C 4, U 5, L 6, and A is 7th position. So you will get our output as 7. Same thing, if there is a E in this, if there is a E in the customer name in the second position, string, what I want? I want E. I'm giving in a double quote, occurrence in the second place. In the second position, this I want to know. So I'm giving this. I'll click on this OK. Now I'm taking this and I will drop it here. Now see, it says 169, 272. So this one, second position, I'm changing this into attribute. Now see here, in this Aaron Bergman, in this, there is only one E, there is no two E's. So here we have E in a first place, another one is last is a place. Okay, so you have to count the place. A-D-A-A-D-A-M space B-E. Adam is 4 character, space is 5, B, E, L, L, A, B, A, N, C, E. So the last E is in the 15th position. If you count the last E, the first E we have to ignore, second E, because we have asked second E's position. So second E's position is 15. And here if you see, it is in 3rd position. So you have like this. Suppose
okay, ma'am,
here
understood.
We have a 6th position. Okay, like this, whichever the position you will be checking, you will be getting this. Understood this?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, second is position. Now what we will do, we will go for the next function. Suppose if there is a name, that starts with some particular character or somewhere it is. So what I want to do, I want to check with the text that starts with, create a calculations. So let's take here, text starts with AN, we will take AN, so we will see. Okay, starts with string customer name, comma, substring. What I have to get it? I have to get the text that starts with AN. Okay, I'll click on this. Okay, now what this is going to give me an output, it will not give me the number of character, because see, it says here equals to T and F, true or false. If there is a text that starts with AN, it will give me true. If it starts with some other character, it will give you as false. So I'm dragging and dropping it. Now see, everything is false. Okay, here we have something which starts with AN. So see here, true. Starts with AN everywhere, it is true. Okay, you can go for this, edit the filters. So third character, second character, anything, whatever you want to do, that you can do. So this one, I will remove none and I will take here, which one starts with AN, that it is not showing me. Okay, so what I will do, so here you have an option. If you want to sort this, you can click on the sort. So first it shows you false, true, everything. Okay, so wherever there is an starts with an, it says you true. Okay, same thing you can try with the other one also. So we have given here starts with, so have taken here an for this. I've given this function. Okay, next one. Okay, try this, then I'll go for the next one. Have you all done it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then we will go for the next one. So we will go with ends with. So string, or I'll take here text. Ends with ER. We will take it as ER. So ends with string is a customer name, comma, substring is ER. I'll close the bracket, double quote, click on this OK. Now I take this. This also will give you an output saying that true or false. Wherever the function that ends with ER. So it has to say be true. Let's check this. Edit ends with ER. See, since I turned into lowercase, so now it says me true, ends with true. Yeah, right. So you have an option ends with ER, ends with ER. So here also ends with ER. So wherever the function that ends with ER, it shows you true. So I have to use the lowercase. So ends with ER is a function. Try to do this. Have you all done?
Yes, ma'am.
So next one, instead of starts with or ends with, what we will do if anywhere in between or somewhere, wherever it is, if it is containing this particular character, then we will take that as containing with. Okay, so let's do here. We will go for the calculation field, create a calculation field. Text contains. ARE. Okay, we are taking here ARE anywhere, wherever it is. We are not sure, but whether if it is containing, let's see here anything if we get it here. Okay, so contains string. String is a customer name substring. I want to know if the character contains ARE. I'll click on this. Okay, so we got this. I'll drag this and put it here. So everything is saying here as false. So I don't think so we have somewhere. So let me edit it. I'll go for this. Text that contains ARE. Edit. I will change here to that contains only AR, and I'll click on this. Okay, now see, there are two. Wherever there is a AR containing, that shows me true. So text that contains AR. Okay, this content we have taken here. Okay, let me click on this. Okay, I'll update here. Try to do this. We are done.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So there are other functions like trim and all. So anyhow, trim is just used for reducing the space. The same thing how you have done in an Excel, same thing you will be having. Now what we will do, we will try with the replace. replace what we will do, like something like where is this order id. So we have here hyphen. Instead of hyphen, I want to replace something else, like underscore I want to do, forward slash I want to do, or something. I just want to change this. So in that case, I will be using this function replace. Create a calculation. Might be in some other calculation, some other numbers also, decimal places will be there. I have to replace the decimal places as zero, or round off I want to do, that things also you can do. Now, as of now, we are just replacing the values. Replace hyphen to forward slash we will do. Okay, so here I'm taking replace what we have here, order id, so comma substring. What I have to replace the hyphen, comma, which I have to replace, I have to replace with the forward slash. Okay, I'll click on this. Okay, now excuse me. Let me drag this and drop it here. Now see, everything has been replaced. So for replacing, okay, so what I did, replace hyphen to forward slash we have done. You can try this. If you have done after trying this, let me know.
Ma'am, could you please again show again once again?
See, here what I have is hyphen. I have a hyphen. Instead of hyphen, I have taken here forward slash. I want to replace with forward slash. So replace, what is a string? String is a order id, comma, what is the content I have? I have a hyphen within a double quote, comma, replace it with the forward slash, close a double quote. Okay, then you can click on this. Okay, so now see, it has been replaced. Suppose instead of this forward slash, I will use here as underscore I will use. Okay, so I will go for this edit. So instead of this, I will use here underscore, and I will click on this. Okay, now can you see here CA underscore 2014 underscore the ID number. So how you want to give like that, you can try. So I have tried this first method, then second thing, again when I'm showing you now, I try the same thing, but instead of using this forward slash, I use a underscore. Then you can replace the value. Try this.
Okay, ma'am, thank you. Done, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am,
Now,
can we
this is
only
what we
replace? Sorry, I just had a question, ma'am. Can we only replace things like a comma or a slash or something like that, not words?
You can replace words also.
Okay, ma'am.
Suppose
Okay.
here I have a 2014. I want to replace 2014 to 2017 like that. 2018 like that also you can do. You can replace it. Even CA, I want to change it to some other text. That also you can do. You can change to text also.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so now what we will do after this text function, that is string functions, now we will go for date and time. So we have a two types of date. One is ship date, the next one is order date. We can choose anything. So let's go with the order date itself. I'm taking this order date. So this is showing me what? It is only showing me the date. So what I will do, I'll go for this drop down and I will say this option. So month, date and year, this option I wanted. And I'm going to take it into the table format. So this, I'll drop it here. So I got this 4th January to 15, whatever it is, this you will be getting here. I'll show you once again. I'll clear the screen. What I'm doing is I'm bringing the order date, dropping year. It shows me year. So you have a plus mark here to increase quarter. Again, you have this next one. After quarter plus, so month, then a day, like this you have. Instead, what I will do, since this is in a day format, I have this drop down. I'll click on this drop down. I have an option year day, May 8, 2015. This option, I will click on this. This is showing me in a table format. I mean, in a column chart, I will select this table format. And this is showing me in a row. I will drag this, sorry, this column heading, it is showing me. I'm putting into a row. So this I can see one below the other. So date of order days, days of order days, it is showing me. Now what I want to do, I want to see only the days, only the month, only the year. In that case, how to use it? I'm going for the function create. So I will take here as function day. Day is nothing but the date. Okay, like 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, that you have an option day. So day is what? So date, I'm using a order date. See here. See, there is an example given here. So 2004, 4, 12. So date, what it will give me? It will give me 12. So 3rd January 2014, it has to give me 3. So 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 13, 14. This is what it has to give me an output. So I'll click on OK. Function day, I'll drag and drop it here. Only the date it is showing. But see, first one shown me 3 and fourth one, it has become 12. So what is happening? Wherever there is 3 option, it is aggregating that. So what we will do, we will click on this drop down, convert this into attribute. Now it will show you the exact number of days, what it is having. Okay, so let me put it here. Date functions. First one is day. Let me give an example here. 2014. Then this will give you output as 30. Okay, so this is what we have here, option in a day. Okay, so next one, I'll create the one more also, then I'll give you a time to do it. I'll go for this again, create a calculation failed. Now I want function month. So which month it is, this I want to find it. So here I go, I'll take here as month. So you can see it, fourth month, fifth month, whatever it is. Date is order date. And save this. Let me take this function month and drop it here. Now you can see function month, it is showing me again some values. I'll convert this into attributes. See, January everything is in 1, Feb is in 2, March is in 3. So all these things. So what I will take, I have done here the month. Month, what it will show you? Jan means today is 1. It has to show me option as 1 if it is a January. If it is a December, suppose if it is a December, it has to show me 12. Next one I will do, we will go for year also. I'll go for this create a calculation field, function year, and here is date, order date. One click on this, okay. So this has to give me 2014. So I'll drop it here. Function year, I will drop it here. So function year, it is showing me again. I'll convert this into attribute so you can see this. Let me just expand it. Now you can see function day, month and year, whichever the format you will be taking. So it will show you according to the date format whatever you are choosing. So year, date. Let me take this as an example. So I'll drop it here. So it is what? It is showing me 2014. Let me change this also to December. Try this. Once you have done all the three functions, do let me know.
Code
Have you all
idea.
done?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now see, I have a day, month, and the year which we have calculated. Suppose assume that when we have a raw data we have downloaded or we got from our clients in order to prepare the data visualization, and day, month, and year is in a different columns, three different columns. In that case, how we will make it into one single date? Okay, only one single date. I don't want three different columns. In that case, how to make it? So what we will do? We will go for the create a calculation field. So we will take it as make date. We have a function make date. So year, so year means we have a formula function year. I'm going to use that function year, comma. Then it is asking me month. Can you see here month? So month, we have used here another formula, function month. So I'm taking here function month, comma. Then it is asking me date. So we have used another function as date. Okay, so function month, function date. This we have taken, which we have already calculated. I'll click on this okay. Now I'll drag this and put it here. Can you see make year of make date? Okay, so this it is showing me. Now what I will do, I'll go for this drop down, I'll take this day format. Now it is showing me the formula make date. Let me take it into a format of this. I'll take this down. This also here. So day and make day, same function we have. So what I will do, now we have already found the options, right? Function day, I'll drag and drop it here. Then again we have function month, I'll drag and drop it here. Then I have a function year, again this also I'll drag and drop it here. So now only thing is we have to convert this into attribute. I'm converting all the three values into attribute. I think there is some disturbance from the others. Could you please mute? If you have a questions, please unmute and ask me. Otherwise, please mute it. See, this is a days of order ID, order date, and this is from the make date. Both are having the same dates. So like this, you can create it. Okay, make date. So whatever the function we had it, okay, make date. So what, by using day, month, year. So for this we have used this function. You can try this. That's done.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you all done? Okay. So now what we will do? We will find the difference between the date. So we already had an option. So what we will do? Yeah. Let's go for the next sheet. I have a order date and ship date. Excuse me. Here I'm converting into date format. This also I'm converting into date format. I'll click on this table. Ship date, this also I'll convert into date format. So here also date format, and here also I'm converting into date format. Let me click on this order date and ship date. So both the dates, see, which was ordered on 4th, it was delivered on 8th. Which was ordered on 5th, it was delivered on 12th. Which was ordered on 6th, it was delivered on 7th, 8th and 10th. Three dates. Now I want to find the difference between this two date. Okay, so what we will do, we will go for this date difference. Date difference, I'll go for this date difference, diff date difference, date part, what I want to find the difference. So days you want to do, month you want to do, so what it is that you have to take. So I'm going to take here as day. You can use double quote or single quote, anything is fine, since we have an habit of using double quote in a Excel. So here also I'm using a double quote itself. Okay, then what it says, it says a start date. Start date is order date, comma, end date. So end date I will give here as ship date. So ship date. Okay, this is enough. We don't want the week and all. I'll click on this OK. Now I'll take this and drop it here. So the difference. So might be there is some other dates of calculation, so we will take it as attribute. Now the number of days, see, from 3rd to 7th, 4 days difference. 4th to 8th, 4 days difference. 5th to 12th, 7 days difference. The number of days that is having a difference is been given here. So days in a difference, date difference we are finding here. So what we have done, I want to find the difference in days. If you want to find it in a month, you can type it as month. If you want to find it in year, you can find it as years. So whatever the difference you will be finding, that you can give. So we have taken year as date. So date difference. Between order date and ship date. Try to do this. Let me know when you have done.
Done, ma'am.
What about others? Okay, so now what we will do, this is a date of order, this is a date of shipment. Suppose I also want what will be the possible date or days of return. Suppose if I'm having within 10 days they can return, if they are going supposed to return within 10 days, so from the day one within which date they can return it. Suppose 3rd is done, so 7th is a ship date, so from 7th 10 days, from 7th 10 days, what will be the possibilities of returning the goods, and that date we have to see. Okay, so what we will do, we will make here add date. Okay, add date, so that is plus 10 days to ship date. This is what we are doing. So in this 10 days is enough, I will remove this 10 days. Then I'm going here, okay, add date, date added, okay, date part, I want it as day. I want to add it here as day, comma, intervals, the number of days, that is 10, comma, date, to which one? To ship date. To ship date. This is what I want to add. The number of days to be added. So how many days? 10 days. To which one? To ship date. We need to add it. I'll click on this OK. Now we have this order date added. I'll drag this and put it here. So this is also showing me in a of which format? Only the year format, I'm converting into date format. So we'll convert into table. Let me take this here. Then order date, ship date. I'll drag this date added here. Can you see 7th, 17th, 8, 12, 22, 7. 17th, so the number of days which has been added. Okay, so the number of days which has been added have given here. You can work on this.
Done, ma'am.
Done, ma'am.
Okay, good. So let's see the next one. So that's all we have in a day function. So other than that, what we have used to have in Excel, those functions also we have it here. So say it like, what is today's date is if I want to find. So today, let me take it here as function today. So I'll take here as today, open bracket, close bracket, that's all. Click on this OK. I got this function today. So you will get this today's date. So let me show it in a date format. So see, 30th July. So I'll put it into table format. So 30th July 2024, like this. So next one, suppose you have some other requirement. Date also I want, time also I want. So in that case, you can use the function now. Function now. So let's try that also. I'll go for this, create a calculation field. So I'm giving here as function now. Am I audible to you all? Because my voice is too low today.
Yes, ma'am.
So now I'm giving, I'll click on this OK. Again, I take this and I will drop it here. So this one, again, I will convert into whatever the format you want to see. Suppose today I will remove, this is what it is showing. So now we'll display the date and time. We will see here. So exact date, what it is, see, exact date. So what is the date, what is the time, everything, it will show you exact date when you are converting. I'm taking the next one, function today, and I will drop it here, ABC. So today also I'll convert into day format, like this. So see, function now, function today, both are shown here. So you can try this. Just need to type now, open bracket, close bracket, enter. You may just need to type a today, open bracket, close bracket, enter. Equals to is not required, but whereas when you're trying the same thing in your Excel, equals to is required when you're working on it. Have you all done?
Yes, ma'am.
Next one. Save. Now, I have here subcategory. Let me take it here, the profit. Profit. See, this is the profit, what is earned. Okay, so profit. Okay, sorry, I have taken a quantity. I have to take a profit. So this will be having a minus value. You can see there is one minus value. Here you have one minus value. Here you have a minus value. Okay, so before that, let me show you another one. I'm only taking a profit and I'm putting here. I'll convert this into table value. So this is a total profit. Total profit. And there are some minus value also. I want that minus value to become a plus value. So what I will do, I'll go for this create. Okay, I will take here as absolute. Absolute profit. I'm taking here as abs. So what it is? Profit. Profit value. So what this absolute will do, it will remove the minus sign and it will give you in a plus value. I'm clicking on this OK. Now I'll take this absolute and put it into this text. Can you see the difference? Two difference. Okay, same thing I'm going to do now. I'll take this subcategory. I have here the profit. Profit. So when I take this profit, you have a minus value. Same thing, without minus value I want it. So I have here absolute profit. I will drag and drop it. So see here, see the difference. So minus sign, without minus sign, it will show you the values exactly the same thing in a plus value. So by ignoring the minus value, it is showing you the value. Now what I want to know, if this is my profit, actual profit, and this is without, with the minus sign, then what is the loss I want to find, right? So what we will do, we will go for this creation, create calculation field. So loss, I want to find the loss. So what I have an absolute profit, the formula which we have worked now, minus the profit value. Then I'll click on this, okay. Now I have this loss, I'll drag this and put it into text. Now this is my loss. I can find the total loss here. So what we have done is, we had a function called as abs. Abs. So this will give you the value without minus sign. So this will give you a value without minus sign. You have the same thing in Excel also. Let me show you in Excel also. Excel. So I will take a value here equals to rand between, random values between minus 50 comma plus 50, close the bracket, enter. I got some value. So there are some minus value also. I'll copy and paste it here. So without formulas. Now you can observe this. There are some minus value also. There are some minus value. Same thing I wanted without minus sign. Abs, absolute. I'll select this value. Close the bracket. Enter. So this is not having any sign. So same value. 42, same value. But see, 14, it is without minus sign. It will come. So when without minus sign, that means you can add it. So when I add this, this is the value 77. When I add this, there is no minus sign, so this is the value. So minus sign we have. So here I am minusing. This is a total profit which it shows without minus sign, and this with minus sign. So I'll come to know what is my loss. This is what we have worked here. Okay, so without minus sign, this will show me the value. So after this, to find the loss, what I have done is, I was having a absolute profit, okay, and the actual profit, what it was showing me, that I have taken to minus it. So once it is done, it will give me the loss value. So for this, let me show you the calculation. Absolute profit. So I have here loss. Edit. Okay, so this is what I have done. You can try doing this now. Have you all done?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Do you have any doubts for today's session?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Here we are ending with the functions. We will see some additional filters and other features, what is available. Then we will go with the advanced charts. Okay, you can practice whatever we have covered till now. And in case any doubts, you can ask me in our next class. Fine?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
So that's all for today. We'll see tomorrow's session.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.